How did you get into sales enablement?
In general, I'm a 20-year product marketing veteran and just loved my job and had done it for several software companies. And the thing I enjoyed doing the most and was literally best at was working with the sales and field teams. So when enablement really became a thing, I jumped over to it and I haven't looked back. It's been about 7 or 8 years now that I've led enablement organizations.
So let's talk about the theme where you want to talk about coaching.
Well, yeah, my idea is the thing that I did a few months ago based on the position I'm in now at Sage Intacct was that we weren't doing enough enablement for the sales managers, frontline and the upper level sales managers who are really focusing on the end users. We had a lot of issues with people either getting bad coaching or no coaching at all from their sales management. So we got some sales training from Matt Cameron in Frontline Selling, and at our kickoff a few years ago we introduced it, and the best part about that was that he introduced five different roles, five hats you can wear while you coach. And that actually narrows down the skill to be able to assess every single coaching system and then decide what this particular incident needs regarding your infusion as a manager. So we decided to sort of set a quota for the number of coaching sessions per employee, per manager, every month. And if we did that, we had to make it reasonable, we had to have it make sense, and have it be something that just naturally worked in their roles. So we built an app inside of Saleshood, which is our enablement platform, that allowed them to enter the coaching situation by entering the hat that they used to coach, who they were coaching, what the situation was, and how it ended. And we require 2 coaching sessions per month, per employee.
You got me in a state of suspense. Now I want to know, what are the five hats?
The five hats are pretty basic. A lot of people think the only way that you should interact with your subordinates is to manage them. And really, truly managing is a type of coaching. You can also coach as just a coach. And this is where they're responsible for production, yes, but they're also responsible for how the reps excel and execute. Same thing is about leadership. If what you need to do is lay down a vision about what you want to do and have that coaching system go to that, you can coach as a leader. There are times when experience is necessary in a coaching session. So another hat is being a mentor. And as you're saying and working with past experience, instead of saying, let me show you what I can do, you stand over there, you help them understand what you've seen in the past work and get their input and then their involvement in trying something new based on past experience. And then the last hat we do is if it's all about training, right? If they don't have a certain skill or they need to understand about a product or a set of talking points or get the story down, you can coach as a trainer. And with coaching, leading, managing, mentoring, and training, you can fine-tune how you coach to the situation.
How do you measure how the sales manager is actually making a difference in the sales rep?
So we do 3 ways to be able to manage this. Number one, we have interviews with the management team. See what's working, what's not, what seems to be more in line with their style. And then we actually can adjust the way they manage based on their specific perspectives. Number two, we talk with the sales teams and find out if they're dreading their one-on-one anymore or if they're actually happening the way that they're, you know, purported to be, or if there's some things that need change sort of on their perception and how they go into a coaching session. And then the last one is that we take all that and we sort of subjectively take a look at performance. And we have a record of what was coached on, and the record is pretty clear. And we can go back and see if the deals that were coached on from a training standpoint or a mentoring standpoint actually closed, or go into our CRM and look at the notes on that and kind of correlate it to the date that the coaching happened. And so far it's been, we calculate about a 45% impact positively on most all coaching sessions that has happened. And we only started a few months ago. So we expect that number to go up, but management is thrilled because no longer do they have complaints from the salespeople about my boss doesn't understand me, I never get to talk to him or her, that kind of thing. And the managers have a roadmap to success for being able to know exactly when to coach and how. And so the biggest success, I think, is that the culture is enhanced enormously. And there's nowhere to really go but up when you've got that.